Yeah, so I'm just making sure these are really clean, so it's very, very clear and super sharp.
Hey, I'm Matt Celia. I'm with Lightsail VR. Today, I have the awesome opportunity to hang out with Sam Newton, who's one of my favorite cinematic filmmakers on YouTube, and I get to show him the magic of working in VR. So welcome.
Thank you for having me. I'm stoked. I have literally never once shot in VR, so I'm excited to see what we get into.
Back in 2021, Canon introduced the EOS VR system, featuring the game-changing RF 5.2mm f2.8L dual fisheye lens. And I told you that this lens was going to set the bar for 180 VR filmmakers. And folks, I was right. I know that for me, it became an essential item in my kit. With a simple lens swap, I was able to turn my EOS R5 and R5C cameras into professional 180-degree 8K VR cameras. It was a pivotal moment for the art form, and it welcomed in a ton of new creative minds eager to craft immersive experiences. Well, I have some really exciting news to share with you today on behalf of my friends at Canon. I remember when the EOS R6 Mark II mirrorless camera came out, and it was Sam Newton who did the launch film. It was beautiful. And I also remember thinking that travel and immersive filmmaking go so well together. Luckily, we both live in Los Angeles, and we both love Canon cameras. So it was a natural fit to invite him to come explore immersive filmmaking with me. Why? Because the first huge announcement is that the EOS VR system is now compatible with the EOS R6 Mark II. To make this happen, you just need to update the firmware to 1.2.0 or later, which is free, by the way, and use at least version 1.3.0 or later of the EOS VR utility or plugin for Adobe Premiere Pro. EOS R6 Mark II owners can now capture 4K virtual reality content when paired with the RF dual fisheye lens. There are a lot of these cameras in the hands of creative people. Now being able to add this lens suddenly gives those owners a brand new tool in their kit, whether they're shooting amazing narrative videos, travel experiences, or anything else they dream up.
I know when you make your videos, you think a lot about the shallow depth of field and how you create focus with that depth of field. But in VR, what you want to do is you want to create that focus with depth.
While I typically capture 8K on my R5C, I'm really impressed with the quality of the 4K image on the EOS VR system. Being able to capture at 60p means your 3D is going to look sharp and smooth, avoiding the stutter effect you can sometimes get while watching material shot at lower frame rates in a headset. You get the best of Canon's color science and low light capabilities. And in my experience, post-production becomes a lot easier. Plus, Canon brought over some of my favorite immersive features to the EOS R6 Mark II. There's the magic window overlay that coincides with the standard field of view for YouTube. So you can line up the action in the center of your frame. You can also use the Canon Camera Connect app to dial in your settings and trigger the record button from afar. You'll learn pretty quickly that you don't want to cast shadows into your shot from behind the camera. So the remote setup is a crucial feature, in my opinion.
Look at that. I don't even need to press the camera. I do it all here. What do I need you here for?
I know.
And you don't just have to capture video. Stereoscopic stills are super fun. I take them all the time when I'm traveling, and this camera does both and captures them at the full sensor resolution, so they look really sharp in headset. Just one quick call out. The EOS R6 Mark II doesn't have the focus guide feature that folks might know from other cameras in the EOS VR system. Don't worry though, you can easily check to make sure your shot is in focus by tapping the magnifying glass twice for maximum zoom and focusing here. Press the info button to switch sides of the lenses automatically and use the thumbstick to pick a part of your frame you want to focus on. Personally, I always like to turn on focus peaking just to make sure I've got it. And honestly, this is how I focus my other cameras as well. Okay, let's talk about some other amazing updates that come along with version 1.3.0 and benefit EOS R5 and R5C users too.
We're in VR, man. It's picking up everything.
You can see everything. You can be like all the way over here.
I can be over here. Okay, I can be on this rock.
In the frame.
It's still getting me.
This might be my favorite new feature, and it's going to save a lot of work. Experienced immersive creators know that camera motion in VR has to be handled carefully, and even the smallest bump or jostle can make your viewer sick. It's why we always recommend slow and steady motion. But you also know that as creative storytellers, we really, really like to push the limits of what's possible when it comes to motion. That's where Canon has really come through for us. Now, With a click of a button in the EOS VR utility app, you can add image stabilization to smooth out your movement of your image. This used to take expensive software, a bit of knowledge, and a lot of time to get right. The first time I tried this, I was blown away. Even the smoothest gimbal always has a bit of bump to it, and this took it right out, making a huge difference to my eyes when I watched the footage back in a headset. But look, it's not gonna solve everything. Handheld footage will still look too uneven. But the new image stabilization feature is a lifesaver for those who need a steady tracking shot or to correct blur in a stationary shot. Some important notes: this will only be available in the EOS VR utility for now. Also, you'll need to have a computer with a GPU processor, and it's going to work best for clips longer than 10 seconds and ones that feature specific subjects. Canon provides a neat little indicator to show which clips are eligible, and while it's processing, you can still use the app to preview other clips. To activate image stabilization, you'll need to be a paying subscriber of the Canon Imaging App Service Plan, which is included in your $5 a month fee. And here's something a little extra for those shooting RAW on the EOS R5 and R5C. Canon has greatly improved the amount of control you have over the sharpening. I can't stress how important it is to sharpen your video. It really brings out a lot of the detail that makes your footage appear sharp when viewed inside a headset. I mean, look at the difference here. I'm really excited that Canon continues to improve the image processing options available in the utility, because it's gonna help creators get the most out of their footage.
I'm excited to see what this is actually gonna look like in
the
VR,
headset. Well, why don't you come back to our studio?
All right.
And I'll put you in a headset and we can see what we shot.
Let's dive in, let's get virtual.
How's the 3D look?
Wild. Exactly what you said. You could see the layers of the mountains. Mm-hmm. Oh my, yeah, this is crazy. It definitely gets your mind going in a completely new way, which is interesting. And as a filmmaker, I feel like there's so much potential to this. Here, I'll set this down.
Okay.
I think the coolest thing about it, right, is I already shoot on the EOS R6 Mark II. It's a lens that I can just throw in my bag, and that opens up an entirely new world of creative possibilities. And as a travel filmmaker, I think we're always looking for that.
Well, dude, thank you so much for your time today. I had a blast getting out to go hike and shoot some amazing VR with you. I'm really excited to have filmmakers like you take this and run with it, because I can't wait to see what you create.
Yeah, and you out there.
Yes. That was awesome. And I sincerely love that feeling when someone creative sees the potential storytelling in VR. Okay, I have one last very cool update to share, and it is one of the most requested features from VR creators. It also continues the theme of this update in making immersive filmmaking easier and more accessible. With the EOS VR utility, you have the option to export your 180-degree footage into a 360-degree workspace. The software will automatically add black space around your image, so the focus is still on your frame. Why is this such a big deal? Well, some third-party NLEs only natively work in the 360 format. You used to have to reformat your exports in order to use the built-in immersive features of those NLEs. So now, no matter your editing software of choice, Canon is meeting you where you like to work and giving you a solution to keep creating. I think Canon has really delivered on their promise of building an immersive ecosystem with the new firmware for the EOS R6 Mark II and version 1.3.0 of the EOS VR software. I'm more excited than ever to check out all the VR stories you create. If you're new, take a look at the description below for some great videos to help you get started. From everyone at Lightsail VR and at Canon, I'm Matt Celia. Thank you for watching.